Thank you, and now we're on to our last one, which is number C. Is the people here for C?
Could I be recognized?
Yes, ma'am, you can.
As things sometimes go during session, it is unpredictable. Mr. Coates represents Representative Fine in this matter, and they contacted me realizing that there were a couple of PCBs that had to be presented by Representative Fine this morning with the Appropriations Committee. The deadline wasn't until yesterday at 4:30 for that agenda. It was a shorter agenda, so we had hopes that maybe this meeting would run such that they could be here. I have been in contact with his office. They are unable to be here, but Mr. Fine wishes for the commission to proceed with consideration of this matter. He did not wish to request a continuance.
Okay. So, with that said, this is the probable cause hearing of complaint number 22-079 and was in Lee Randall Fine. And being up there, Ms. Miller, Ms. Hanley, you're recognized.
Respondent serves as a member of the Florida House of Representatives. His district includes Brevard County. I'm going to rehash some previous actions you may have heard in a different case. In early April 2022, complainant, a school board member, received and accepted an invitation to participate in the Cops on the Coup, which proceeds go to the Florida Special Olympics. Once it was announced, City Council member John Dittmore posted an apology to the respondent and the Florida Attorney General about complainant's participation. She alleges that she was targeted for her political views and acknowledged that she and the respondent have had prior acrimonious dealings. Complainant alleges that Dittmore was encouraged by respondent to write the response, but acknowledged she had no evidence to support the allegation. She further alleged that the respondent and Dittmore posted slanderous comments about her. Dittmore advised that he was concerned that when complainant publicized her participation in the fundraiser, her supporters mocked respondent, and since respondent is instrumental in supporting the city and its projects, he was concerned that her participation could jeopardize funding for a stormwater reduction project. In anticipation of those issues, Dittmore initiated the post on his private Facebook page apologizing to respondent. Dittmore maintains that he was not encouraged by anyone, including respondent, to write the apology. However, the following day, Dittmore received a text from respondent stating, "Thanks for taking care of it. Jenkins, who's the complainant, just put your project and Special Olympics funding on the veto list," end quote. Complainant contacted the then city attorney, Morris Richardson, who informed her that he and Dittmore had concerns about state funding for the reduction project, as well as concerns about respondents' displeasure with her involvement at the fundraiser. Attorney Richardson encouraged her to reconsider participating in the fundraiser because it could possibly jeopardize funding for the city from the state. However, there was no controversy during the fundraiser and the city received the anticipated funding. The respondent in this case advised that he did not encourage Dittmore to write the Facebook post, but acknowledged all of his communications with Dittmore concerning the Facebook post were in text messages included in the complaint. Respondent acknowledged making disparaging comments directed toward complainant in his text communications with Dittmore. He viewed complainant's participation in the fundraiser as having a very high risk of antagonizing Governor Ron DeSantis and opined that it could have led to the governor vetoing funds for the reduction project. Now, subsequent to the contact with Attorney Richardson, complainant submitted a public records request for all of Dittmore's communications, including Facebook messenger communications, text messages, cellular phone logs, and emails to and from respondent in April 2022. When Dittmore met with Attorney Richardson to review the text messages, Dittmore informed him that respondent had advised Dittmore to not release any public records. Respondent had also suggested that Attorney Richardson be terminated for providing advice to release the information. He did this by stating, "I wasn't serious about taking your funding away, but if you don't fire your city attorney, I will take away your funding," end quote. Dittmore took the statement as a threat, which he believed to be credible. Dittmore relayed the information to Attorney Richardson because the governor had not yet signed the bill for the reduction project. Attorney Richardson was not terminated, however. Complainant alleges that the public records that were received demonstrate Dittmore's willingness to participate in the threats made by respondent regarding city funding. In addition, complainant contends that in one of the text Respondent denied ever having indicated that he would veto any funding for the city of West, for the city of West Melbourne based on the complainant's participation in the fundraiser. He acknowledged recommending that Attorney Richardson be terminated due to his, to Richardson not understanding the requirements for disclosing public records information. However, respondent said that his comments, Facebook messages, and text messages were made in jest and were not to be considered a serious threat. In addition to the public records request to Ditmore, complainant submitted a public records request to respondent for which she alleges he failed to respond. Respondent said he has no recollection of having received a public records request from the complainant. However, he said if one was submitted to his office, a member of his staff would have been responsible for complying with the request. Respondent advised that he never instructed his staff not to respond to complainant's public records request. Lastly, complainant alleges respondent and Ditmore communicated with the Melbourne mayor about hiring a private investigator to surveil her, but she had no evidence to support the allegation. Complainant acknowledged that she is aware of no evidence supporting her allegation that respondent was involved in creating BrevardBurns.com website, which is devoted to exposing lies, deceit, and fraud involving Robert Burns, the editor of a separate news source. Again, it was the Melbourne mayor who hired the private investigator, and it was to surveil Robert Burns, and complainant just happened to be at the same place at the same time. And respondent and Ditmore denied having any involvement with hiring Sandberg, and both denied any involvement in the BrevardBurns.com website. There are two allegations. In article, first allegation is in is Article 1, Section 8, H2, Florida Constitution, by using his position to obtain a disproportionate benefit for himself or another. While acknowledging that some of the facts presented may reflect negatively on a person in respondent's position, these same facts do not indicate an abuse of respondent's position that allow him or another to receive a disproportionate benefit. I recommend a finding of no probable cause. In the second allegation, respondent is alleged to have violated Section 112.3136 by using his position to secure a privilege, benefit, or exemption for himself or another. Respondent obviously has strong feelings about complainant by his use of strong language about her. Respondent's choice of words would indicate that he was using or attempting to use the power or the threat of his office to intimidate Ditmore into acting in a certain manner regarding complainant. While respondent engaged in public, political, and personal discourse with complainant, an element to prove a violation of the misuse statute requires that respondent act in a manner that was inconsistent with the proper performance of public duties, for which the evidence presented is insufficient to prove. I recommend a finding of no probable cause.
Members, do we have any questions? Seeing none, is there a motion?
I move to reject the advocate's recommendation and find probable cause.
Okay, is there a second?
Second.
Oh, interesting. Okay, see that it's properly second, and is there any discussion?
What?
Sir.
Thank you. I find what Representative Fine has done reprehensible. It may, and ultimately, if this motion passes and we find probable cause, then this is referred to the House of Representatives for them to deal with. I spent 8 years in the Florida House of Representatives and never partook in any type of activity like Representative Fine has done outside. That is not the proper exercise of a state legislator. While other cases, we may, other cases related to this, we may have taken a different view, this one, there is nothing here that is the proper exercise of your duties as a state legislator. Therefore, I think that he is certainly in a position where this ought to be referred to the House of Representatives for them to deal with and take the appropriate action. It would not go, as I understand it, does not go to a DOA hearing. Am I wrong?
Madam Executive Director, you recognize.
This matter, through the chair, would proceed as other complaints do. It just would be once the recommended order or the settlement agreement was reached, it would go to the House for imposition. Is that correct?
Okay, I stand corrected. Either way, this is something that is not the proper exercise of a public official, and it's certainly not a state legislator.
Okay. Any other comments or questions? Sir, you're recognized.
I think this incredibly petty kind of discourse is all too indicative of the level of interchange that we have come to in politics across this nation, but I don't know that I think it is so egregious that we should be sending it forward. I can't support the motion.
Okay. Excuse me. Is there any other comments or questions? Seeing none. Okay, so we have a motion that's properly motioned and second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay.
No.
See, that has properly been approved. So it has been rejected, and it will move forward to, go ahead. So the motion on hand was that Commissioner Wallman is rejecting the no probable cause. We do find probable cause. It was second, and it was approved by the commission.
Do you need that for the minutes, or are you good?
What was the vote?
It was
a vote to reject the advocate's recommendation and find probable cause on both counts, allegations.
All right.